Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm talking about forehead Botox and Dysport. Botox was just FDA approved for the forehead, and the dosing was 20 units. You're going to hear about an M pattern of injecting or kind of a V pattern, but there's no one pattern because the movement's always a little bit different based on the assessment. The 20 unit dosing, however, is a little bit of a problem. Remember, that's just to get it FDA approved. The average dosing, if you ask clinics in the real world, is about 12 units of Botox or about 30 units of Dysport. Many people use Dysport and they make an equivalent Botox amount, so we talk in Botox units to keep it simple. So, what do you expect with the forehead? The forehead, the biggest thing you notice is a bit of a droop because the only thing the forehead does is lift. And this is what I wanted to warn and talk a little bit about today, was what do you do if you get a Botox or Dysport drooping? And is it an eyelid droop or a brow droop? The most common by far is the brow lowering because that M or that V didn't fit perfectly to the anatomy of the patient. And that goes away on its own. It typically lasts maybe 1 week, two, three, by four or five, certainly the brows are up again, especially with that 12 unit dose. The lid drooping is very rare, and that's often from a high insertion of the levator palpebra muscle, which is what lifts the eyelid basically. And if it's genetically or just anatomically higher, it's easier to get, or it can be injector error that the injections were done too low. It's typically one or the other. Drops can be used, they don't work all that well. You use them a few times a day, it can help elevate the eye if it droops. The beautiful thing about Botox and Dysport, and if it's a problem, it goes away because it wears off, of course. On the flip side, when it's a great result, people want it to last forever. So Botox and Dysport in the forehead work very, very well. The dosing is typically around 12 units. It's normal, especially as we age, to get a little bit of a lowering of the brows. And just because you never had lower brows before doesn't mean you can't get them a second time, because remember, the body's response is going to be variable. It's not always going to be the same. The anatomy's changing. Some muscles are getting bigger. Some are atrophying. And the eye socket, of course, gets larger and rotates as we age. All those things make one treatment different than the next on a regular basis, especially with the forehead, a paper-thin muscle, and a large muscle. So let us know your experience below about Botox and Dysport in the forehead, and ask some further questions if you have them. Also, join Facebook and Instagram for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.